हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज क्लास थर्ड। क्लास थर्ड जीएससी and we are studying lesson 13, air and water. Lesson 13, air and water. In this lesson, we have studied about the air, as air contains water vapors, air contains gases, air contains smokes, air contains germs. Now, we have to study about the water in this lesson. So, water. Just like food, living things need water. We cannot live very long without water. Other than drinking, we need water for various purposes like cooking, cleaning, bathing, washing, watering plants, putting out fire, etc., etc. These are the different uses of the water. Our earth is 70% water, which occurs in the form of rivers, ice, oceans, seas and lakes. So these are the different sources of the water. I told you different uses of the water for the drinking, bathing, washing, watering plants, etc., etc. Water is needed. And water is found in ocean, sea, rivers, lakes, ponds, etc., etc. Now, forms of water. Forms of water. Forms of water. You know the three states of matter? I've told you last time. And three states of matter, solid, liquid and gases. Water is found in all the three forms. In the form of the water, in the form of the liquid, in the form of the solids, and in the form of the gases. So we have to read, water in its natural state is in the liquid form. Water in its natural state is in the form of liquid. It flows. It does not have a definite shape, but gets the shape of the container. This is properties of liquid. Liquid has no shape. Liquids take the shape of the container in which they are kept. So such properties are also found in the water in the natural state. So if you pour it into a glass, it will take the shape of a glass or if you pour it into a bowl, it take the shape of a bowl. Suppose you are taking water. This is glass. Suppose this is glass. You are taking the water. And if you pour this water in a vessel which is circular in the shape of the liquid will be circular. And if you are keeping this water in a vessel which is rectangular in the shape of the water will be rectangular. And if you pour the water in a vessel which is conical in the shape of the water will be conical. In this way, we can say that water has no its own shape. Its shape is changed according to the vessel, according to the shape of the vessel in which they are kept. If we boil water, it changes into steam. You are familiar to the steam. You know that when your mother is the boiling water for making the tea, etc., it's get converted into steam. And steam is the form of the liquid. When the pressure cooker, when your mother is cooking food, steam coming out. Steam is the form of the gas. So if we boil water, it changes into steam. Steam rises into the air in the form of gas called water vapor. This steam is the gaseous form of water. It does not have a definite shape. It takes up the shape of the container. The same way as water in the liquid form, it has no any shape. In the same way, when water comes into the in the form of the water vapors, it is the gaseous form of the matter in which it has no its own shape. We can change water vapor into water again by cooling. If we reduce the temperature, the water vapors are converted into water drops by the process of cooling. Hold a cool steel plate over boiling water. Water vapor touches the plate and changes into water drops. So suppose You are heating the water. This is water. It is kept on a stand. It is a stand, and if you heat the water, this is gas stove or the gas burner. This is burner and this is water. Water is heating, and now put a cover. Take a plate and cover the mouth of the vessel. Cover it. Mouth of the vessel and heat it, and when you just open, this is boiling water vapors comes outside, and when you just see the vessels, you can find water drops. If you see water drops on this, this is become water drops are appeared here. How? Because by the heating, water is converted into the gas, and when it reaches and when it come in contact with the cover or with the lid, and it get converted into the water drops. So if we keep water in the refrigerator in the freezing zone, it changes into ice. Ice is the solid form of water. It has a different shape. When we keep ice cubes in a warm place, they change back into water. So if we keep the water into the freezing zone of the refrigerator, it gets converted into the ice. So ice is the solid form of the water. So in this way, one state of the matter may be changed into another state, in other state, or one form of the water may be changed into other forms. By the action of heat, by increasing temperature or by reducing temperature. Thus, ice, water, and water vapor are the three interchangeable form of water. Water changes its form due to the change in the temperature. So next time we will discuss how this change of water takes place into the different states. Thank you, that's all today.